So, hi friends, welcome to TP Chennai. Today we will see 10 arithmetic question and one set of DI, which is based upon speed time distance chapter, right? So, purely based upon IBPS RRB PO bar IBPS RRB clerk bar SBI clerical preliminary examination, right? So first three questions I have written on the board. First one, in a container there are 26 eggs, out of which 6 eggs are rotten. If 2 eggs are chosen at random, what is the probability that at least one egg is rotten? Rotten is nothing but spoil. So first of all, what is the meaning of at least one egg? That means P of x greater than or equal to 1. Right? At least is anything but minimum value. It can be more than that also. I can write this as 1 minus P of x less than 1. Or I can say 1 minus P of x equal to 0. Less than 1 is equal to 0. That means I don't want any rotten x. So remaining how many x I am having? 20. From that I need to choose 2. So total number of possible cases are 26C2. Right? Now don't subtract here, because don't write 26C2 minus 20C2 is 6C2 divided by 26C2. No. You have to calculate this one separately. So 20C2 is 20 into 19 divided by 2, which is 190. And 26C2 is nothing but 26 into 25 by 2, which is nothing but how much? 325. So this is nothing but how much? 1 minus 190 divided by 325. Or I can say 5, we can cancel. 5 3s are 15, 5 8s are 5, 6 are 5s are. So 1 minus 38 by 65 is 65 minus 38 is 27 by 65 is my answer. This is nothing but first option. Next one. If 35 children can complete a work in 12 days, find in how many days 21 children can complete the same work. Work is constant. Whenever work is constant, capacity ratio is inversely proportional to days ratio. Capacity is nothing but how much they have given you initially? 35 children. Now how many children are there? 21. So capacity is ratio is 35 is to 21. 7 3s are 7 5s are. So days ratio is how much? 3 is to 5. Now how many days he is taking? 12. This is 4 times. This is also 4 times. What is the answer? 20. This is nothing but second option. Third one. Efficiency of Ram is 130% of Raja. If Raja can complete a work in 26 days, in how many days can Ram complete the same work? Same concept. So efficiency of Ram and Raja. So I am writing here Ram. I am writing here Raja. Efficiency of Ram is 130% of Raja. Not 130% more. If 130% fraction value is how much? 13 by 10. If Raja is 10, Ram will be 13. Right? So efficiency or capacity of Ram and Raja is 13 is to 10. If Raja can complete a work in 26 days, whenever you are multiplying efficiency with days, you will get work. So work is how much? 10 into 26. Efficiency of Raja is 10 only. 10 into 26 divided by efficiency of Ram, which is 13. What is the answer? 20 days, which is nothing but third option. So I hope you are clear with the first three questions. Now we will see next three question. Ashok decreases the number by 10% first, then increases it by 15%, and then decreases it by 20%, and in the last he increases it by 25%. Find total percentage change in the value of original number. Fully based upon percentage concept only, right? So 10%, what is fraction value? 1 by 10. Initial value is 10, now value is 9. Then increase by 15%, 15% fraction value 3 by 20. So this is 20, this is 23. And then decrease it by 20% fraction value 1 by 5, this is 5, this is 4. And again increase by 25% fraction value 1 by 4, 4, 5. So cancel this number. This is how much I am writing here, 200, and this is 207. Right? Divide both the sides by 2. So this is 100, this is 103.5. How much it has increased? 3.5%, which is nothing but second option. Next one, at compound interest, if a certain sum of money triple itself in n years, then the amount will become 27 times in how many years? Right? So first I have principal 1 that has become 3 in n years. Again it has triple, so 9 in again another n years. Again this has become triple, so 27 in n years. So total number of years is n plus n plus n, which is nothing but 3n. Next one, a is 36.3 36% less than B, then B is what percent more than A? 36.36% is nothing but 9.09% into 4. And what is 9.09% fraction value? 1 by 11. So this is 4 by 11. Now I am writing here A, I am writing here B. A is 36.36% less than B. If B is 11, A is 11 minus 4, 7. Then B is what percent more than A? So 4 by 7 into 100. 1 by 7 is 14.28, 4 by 7 is 42.85. Which is nothing but first option. So I hope you are clear with the first 6 question. Now we will see 7th one and the 8th one. 7th one, the cost price of a car is 500% more than cost price of a scooter. If cost price of a car is increased by 18% and a scooter by 25%, the total percentage increases in cost price of 7 cars and 10 scooter. Right, so here car and scooter they are saying. This is car, this is scooter. 500% more they are saying, right? That means if the cost price of scooter is 1, this is 6. Because 500% more. Cost price of a car is increased by 18%. Right? This year is going to increase by 18%. And scooter by 25%. Right? Then the total percentage increase in cost price of 7 cars and 10 scooters. Okay, so they are asking to total percentage of 7 cars and 10 scooters. So first we multiply this one by 7 and this one by 10. This is 42, this is 10. So 2 5s are 221s are, right? Ratio is 21:5. Now this I am increasing by 18% and this I am increasing by 25%. And now I need overall change. So I can use slightly weighted average concept here, right? N1 A1 plus N2 A2 divided by N1 plus N2. So 21 into 18 plus 5 into 25 divided by 21 plus 25 is 6. What is 21 into 18? 42 into 9, 378. 5 into 25 is 125 divided by 26. This is 503 divided by 26. 26, 1s are 26, 243. So this is 9 times point, this is nothing but 4 times. 19.4 is the answer, which is nothing but third option. Next one, if Raj decreases his speed by 20%, then he takes 20 minutes more to cover a certain distance. Find out the time taken by him to cover same distance with his original speed. Right? So distance is constant here, same distance. Whenever distance is constant, what is the relationship between speed and time? Inversely proportion. So initial speed ratio is nothing but 20% decreases. That means 20% fraction value is 1 by 5. If initial speed is 5, now it has become 4. So time ratio is 4:5. Here how much more? 1 more. There how much more? 20 minutes. Now what they are asking? Find the time taken by him to cover the same distance with his original speed. That means this one. So 4 part is how much? 80 minutes. Which is nothing but third option. So I hope you are clear with the first 8 questions. Now we will see last 2 questions of arithmetic. 36 men can complete a piece of work in 40 days. X men started the work and after 30 days 64 more men joined them. So that whole work was finished in desired time, find the value of X. Very conceptual question. 36 men can complete a piece of work in 40 days. So work is nothing but how much? 36 into 40, which is 1440. X men started the work and after 30 days 64 more men joined them. Now you tell me one thing, this X men worked for entire 40 days, right? So 40 into X plus, and after 30 days 64 men more men joined. That means the 64 men worked for last 10 days only, because they came after 30 days only, and total work is 1440. So 40x plus 640 is equal to 1440. 40x is equal to 800. X is equal to 20. X is equal to 20, which is nothing but first option. Next one, in an annual examination of 5 subjects, a student scored overall 60% and his marks in 5 subjects were in the ratio 7:8:9:10:11. If maximum mark in each subject are 200, then find out in how many paper he scored more than 55% marks. So overall a student got 60%, right? And his marks in 5 subjects were the ratio 7:8:9:10:11. That means what about average? Average is middle value, which is 9. That means 60% is nothing but 9, right? Because he got overall 60%, which is average only, and here average is 9. So 100 part is how much? This 60 is, if you multiply this one by 5/3, you will get 100. So 100 part is here also multiplied by 5/3, 15 only. Now if maximum mark in each subject are 200, there is no use of this because we don't need to worry about maximum mark. Then find out in how many paper he scored more than 55% marks. 55% of 15. Break this number. 50% plus 5% of 15. 50% of 15 is 7.5. 5% is nothing but how much? 50% is 7.5, right? 5% is nothing but by 10. By 10 is nothing but 0.75. This is 8.25%. Now, just we have to see in this marks where all you are having value more than 8%, which is this one and this one and this one. So your answer is 3, which is second option. So I hope you are clear with the arithmetic question. Now we will see one set of DI. The below table shows different metro train with different speed and different length. So you have different metro train P, Q, R, S, and they have given length of the train in meter and speed they have given you. First one, find by what percent metro S needs to increase its speed to cross the pole in time equal to the time taken by T to cross the pole. Now you just tell me one thing. Whenever a train is crossing a pole, what is the distance covered by the train? Length of the train itself. So what is the length of time taken by P to cross a pole? P is nothing but how much? 250. And speed is nothing but how much? 55 seconds. And time should be same for S. So what is the speed of S? 250, speed of S is 400 by 5, which is 80 meter per second. But what is the speed of S? 20. So 20 is the speed. Now it has become 80. How much it has increased? 60 by 20 into 100, which is 300%. My answer is nothing but third option. So I hope you are clear with the first one. Now we will see second one. Find the time taken by metro R to cross a man sitting in metro S if both are running in opposite direction. So train is crossing a man. What is the distance covered by the train? Length of the train. What is length of metro R? 300. And R and S both are moving in opposite direction. So what will be the relative speed? Sum of speed. R and S 60 plus 20. 80. What is the answer? 8 is 24. 3.75 seconds is the answer. So I hope you are clear with the second question. Now we will see third one. Time taken by T and R to cross each other when they move in opposite direction is what percentage of the time taken by Q and S to cross each other when they move in same direction? Very good question, right? T and R to cross each other when they move in opposite direction. So train of length of train T and length of train R is how much? P and R, 250 plus this 300, 550 divided by when they move in opposite direction, P and R move in opposite direction, which is sum of the speed, 5 second. Second one, Q and S, Q and S, what is the value? 450 plus 400, 850, and when they move in same direction, right? So this is 5, 170 second. So 5 by 170 into 100. So 50 by 70, we can say directly which is nearest to 3. 70 is a 51, we can directly click first option, which is nothing but 3. So I hope you are clear with the third one. Now we will see fourth one. Find the time taken by metro P to overtake metro Q if the distance between P and Q, then is nothing but P and Q is 0.7 km. P and Q distance is 250 and 450, which is 700 plus this one. 0.7 km is nothing but 700 meter. So 700 plus 250 plus 450 divided by overtake. Overtake is nothing but same direction. P and Q, what is the speed? 50 minus 15, 35. This is how much? 1400
divided by 35, what is the answer? 42nd, which is nothing but third option.
So I hope you clear with the previous question. Now we'll see last one. What will be that ratio of time taken by metro P and metro R to cross the bridge of length 750 meter? Length of the bridge they have given you, and whenever a train is crossing a bridge, what is the distance covered by the train? Length of the train plus length of the bridge, right? So length of train P is how much? 250 plus 750, 1000. And what is the speed of metro P? 50. Is to R 300 plus 750 is 1005, and speed of R 60, right? So 10 5s are 10 6 are 5 20s are, right? 5 200s are, and here it is how much? Right, here it is how much? 6 17s are 102.5. Right, so this is nothing but how much? Double this number, 175. So what ratio of time taken by P? P is how much? 250. 250 plus 750 is 1000, and speed of P is how much? 50. 10 5s are, this is 5, 20s are, and then 0 will be there. Okay, so this is 200 and this is 17.5. So what is the answer? 8 is to 7. Right, directly we can say answer is nothing but 8 to 7. So I hope you are clear with 10 arithmetic question and one set of DI which we have seen here. Do subscribe TP Chennai YouTube channel for further updates and videos, and do share this video among your friends and also in Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, right? And please do comment about this video in the comment section. So prepare well. All the best. Thanks a lot.